Hey, this is Leo for Actualize.org, and I'm doing another quick self-help segment where in about 10 minutes, I am going to tell you how to make more money. So this is a fascinating topic to me because I personally like money. Who doesn't? And I like to make more of it and like to look for strategies for how to make more money. And here, I can't cover this topic deeply enough because this is a really deep topic, and I have some really advanced level strategies. Some long-term strategies that you can put into place, but that requires building up some structures. So here, I'm going to give you more practical, more quick-to-implement type of ideas. I think the biggest idea that you need to understand to make more money is you need to start to learn marketing, and you need to understand the principles behind marketing, because marketing is all about how to sell something or convince something of the value of what you have to offer. And marketing is much broader than we initially think it is, because marketing will tell you how to sell yourself to a company, how to sell yourself to an employer, how to sell yourself to a client, how to attract more business, how to even build up a charity and get attention to your charity, even if it's a nonprofit, how to attract the opposite sex, because that also involves using the principles of marketing. So marketing is very important. And what marketing is going to teach you if you start learning it is it's going to teach you that you need to provide value. You need to understand what the other person wants and what is valuable to the other person, because then you can tailor a proposition that will appeal to them. If you're only thinking about yourself and you're thinking about how to leech value from your employer, and you're thinking about how to leech the most value from your clients and your customers or a relationship, I hope you're not doing that in a relationship, then what's going to happen is that it's going to come back to bite you in the ass. So naively, it seems like, well, let's try to leech as much value and we're going to get the most money, right? It doesn't work that way. What I find works much, much better, and what all the self-help gurus out there, all the people that have come before me who have studied this stuff and have really made big successes of their lives, all come to the consensus that you need to be providing value. What does that mean? That means, for example, if you're working in a company and right now you're kind of a mid-level position and like you're a salesman or you're working as an engineer or you're working as an accountant, whatever, and you want to make more money, then, and you want to stay within that same organization, I'm assuming, then what you got to do is you got to provide more value to the company, and you want to provide it in a way where it's obvious to them. So, and you want to provide it in a context that they actually want and they need. So for example, you might go to your boss and you might ask them, so what are you guys like working on next? What's the next big thing? And how can I contribute the most? Like, let's say I really wanted to develop myself and I wanted to build the skills and I could give you guys the most value. What would that look like for you guys? And if I actually went and made all those changes, what would that be worth to you guys? Would you be willing to give me a promotion? Would you be able to give me a pay bump? You know, would I get an extra bonus? What could I get? Can I get some perks? Can I get some more vacation time? So this is how you do it. And you got to look at where the opportunities are, right? Within your company. Like, what are they doing next? What is going to earn them more money? Because whatever earns them more money, they can then justify paying you more. Because if you can earn your company an extra $100,000 a year with what you're doing, either the program that you're writing or the sales that you're making or the customers you're attracting or the advertising you're putting out there, if that's giving them $100,000 cash and they can see that clearly and they can link that to your efforts, then they can understand that it's justifiable to pay you some percentage of that. They can justify paying you probably as much as half of that, but more likely they're going to give you like 10% of that or 20% of that. It all depends on your situation. So look for value. If you're running your own business and you want to make more money, well, that's almost easier. What you got to do is you got to go and ask your clients, interview your clients, and get a deep understanding of what your clients want. What are their real needs? Not what do you think they want, but what do they say they really want? And then tailor your services to really provide that to them. Provide what they want more of, and they're going to pay you for it appropriately, right? So go ahead and ask them. Most entrepreneurs and business leaders actually don't have a a very crystal clear understanding of exactly what it is their clients and their customers want, because they never sat down and went through that process of finding out. That can be a process that requires some work. If you do that, then you're going to increase the amount of compensation you're getting. You're going to increase the amount of money you're charging. Other ways to make more money. Well, simply ask for it. That's a simple one. Have you tried that? How many people have actually asked for more money? A lot of times we have hesitations. We feel like we don't deserve it, or we feel like if we ask, something bad is going to happen, and we're going to get rejected, or we're going to get fired, or the client's going to leave us. Well, in a lot of cases, you're undercharging for your services or your products, whether you're working at a company or you're running a business and selling your own services and products. You can usually charge more. A lot of times, you can charge double more, and you'll be surprised to find that clients and customers and employers will pay for it. It all depends kind of on what your positioning is, but you should at least try. You know, do you go in and ask for a yearly salary bump? Do you at least try to do that? Maybe ask for 10% raise every year. Make it a habit of doing that. Maybe ask for 20% raise. The more you ask, the more you try for it, the more likely you are to get it. If you never ask for raises, no one's just going to come to you and just hand you a raise. And the same thing with your clients. You know, see if you can charge them more. Raise your prices by 10%. Raise your prices by 20%. See what happens. You might be surprised at just how much free money right now you're losing because you're too hesitant and you're limiting yourself in your mind, basically, as to how much you can charge. Because if your clients are getting a lot of value from what you're offering and they don't have a lot of other options to go to, and you're not in a super like commodity competitive business, then you can probably charge more for what you're doing. Which leads me to the last point, which I think I'll talk about here, which is a more fundamental principle about how to earn more money in whatever it is that you're doing. And that is to position yourself into a place where you're providing something unique that other people are not providing. The problem with selling a commodity, like if you're selling gasoline, or if you're selling wheat, or if you're selling something like bubble gum, is that this stuff is, these markets are so competitive that the prices are pretty much set. And you can't really charge much more for bubble gum than it costs. You can't really charge much more for gasoline or for wheat than the market price is set. It's just like there's an industry price. But if you're providing some sort of unique product, some sort of unique service, something you have patented, something that you're doing for a company that nobody else can do, then you have some leverage. Now all of a sudden you can charge more. So it is about creating more leverage in either your business or in your career. In your career, the way you create leverage is becoming very, very good at it. Becoming so good that nobody else is as good as you and nobody can deliver the same kind of results and value as you. So for example, if you're working for a company as their ad guy, advertising guy, their marketing guy, then the better you can market, the more tricks and techniques you know, the more connections you have built with other marketers in the industry, and the more you can leverage them, then the more value you're able to provide. Because again, it's a simple math calculation. If you can provide $1 million worth of value to somebody, then they're going to be willing to pay you at least 10% of that. You're at least worth 10%. So if you can provide $1 million worth of value, they'll give you at least 100,000, maybe more, depending on how good you are at negotiating. And the same thing with your business, right? What are you providing that's unique about your business? How are you setting up your business that you're offering a unique selling proposition, right? That old term, unique selling proposition. How is your product so unique that even if you charge a little bit more for it, customers would still want it? That usually means building up a brand. That usually means building up some unique points, some unique features that will keep customers coming to you even though there are other people out there. So maybe your product quality is exceptionally high. Maybe your service quality is exceptionally high. Whatever that is, maybe you just got amazing branding and you've got, you're like the top of the industry, you're like the industry leader in your niche. That will allow you to charge for more money. And any kind of actions that you can use to build up and elevate any one of those pillars that I just mentioned will allow you to charge for more money. I think the ultimate strategy here is to make yourself unique. And to do that, that means putting in the hard work and the time that it takes to build it up. So it doesn't matter if you're building up a brand for your company and you're investing time and money into building up that brand over, let's say, a span of a decade, you're building up that brand. Or you're doing that with your career and you're building up yourself as a brand, as someone who is an expert in your own industry, whatever industry that is. I mean, if you're like a florist, make yourself a world-class florist. If you're an athlete, make yourself a really world-class athlete. If you're an engineer, become a really talented, accomplished engineer with like patents behind you. Something like that will make you much more marketable. And the final thing that I'll probably end on is, I already mentioned a little bit of this building up your expertise, but I think building up your expertise, but also building up your renown in your industry. So getting a little bit of fame, and I don't mean like celebrity fame, although that can be lucrative in and of itself, but for most of us, it's not about fame, it's about building up a certain authority and expertise. So like I said, within your industry, are you well known? Do you have articles published under your name in your industry as an expert? You don't? Why not? Are you going to all the conventions and the industry events? Are you in touch with the leaders in your industry? Are you friends with them? Are you acquaintances with them? Are you in a mastermind group with them? All of those things will raise your value. First of all, you'll learn so much more. Second of all, you'll have more options. You'll have connections. It's really powerful to have connections, and it's really powerful to have your name out there, because once you have a little bit of a reputation, even if it's just within your narrow little niche, then what happens is that your market value skyrockets. And it doesn't skyrocket proportional to the value you give. It skyrockets much more. Because when people recognize you, think about that. If you go into a job interview and you go in and there's you who has 10 articles published and who has maybe a blog that the people in this industry follow, and then there's the other guy who just has a normal vanilla resume and maybe has 10 or even 20 years of experience, but he doesn't have any sort of image out there, no personal brand built up, who do you think they're going to hire? And who do you think they're going to pay more? You, by a big, big, big margin. So go ahead and start building that up for yourself. Create a strategy for how you're going to do this. Do that for your business. Do that for the brand of your business. And if you're just a career professional, do it for your career. Super, super important. And with career, it usually means building up connections and training, getting lots and lots of training, lots and lots of practice until you're really, really good. All right, that's it. Those are some really excellent ways to build up your money. These are not get-rich-quick schemes. This is how you can actually get more money in a sustainable way that is proven to work. These are timeless principles that are guaranteed to work for you if you just work them. So they're a little bit abstract. You have to go out and personalize them to what you're doing in your life. But I think that you're smart enough to figure out how that can roll. And if you want more advice on how to really make more money, even deeper strategies, then check out actualized.org, because there we really go into what it takes to become super successful, super wealthy, wealthy beyond what you can imagine right now. And to do that, really, it starts with getting your inner game dialed in and developing a certain sense of self-mastery, and then getting your life purpose down. Once you got your life purpose down, and you really committed, and you really know what you want out of life, and you know the kind of value that you want to offer other people, the sky's the limit for you. You will not have a problem with money. You will be making as much money as you want. But that does take some time and some effort to figure out, and there are some tips and tricks that I want to show you. So go ahead to actualize.org and sign up to the newsletter. All right, this is Leo signing off. Go ahead and share this, give me some comments, and like it if you do.